in olden days, a glimpse of stocking was looked on as something shocking, but now God knows anything goes. Put offers to who once knew better words, now only used for letter words, writing prose, anything goes.
I'm starting a new playlist on modesty, and my focus will be on modesty related to the wearing of clothing. Probably the best place to start this playlist is with St. Thomas Aquinas, who said, "We are naturally inclined to be the recipients of the virtue that moderates outward raiment." On one hand, this seems to be a pretty simple topic, but as we're going to see, the other hand shows us that it's more complicated than it might seem. There are three meanings for the word immodest. The first definition means intemperate. However, this definition, although used a lot by the church, is rarely used regarding the wearing of clothing. And clothing is the focus of this playlist. The two definitions that we're considering here is pride and the wearing of clothing in a manner that incites lust. First, regarding the wearing of clothing pridefully. This happens when we wear expensive or ornate clothing to show off or to draw attention to ourselves. St. Ambrose said, "The body should be bedecked naturally and without affection, with simplicity, with negligence rather than nicety, not with costly and dazzling apparel, but with ordinary clothes, so that nothing be lacking to honesty and necessity, yet nothing be added to increase its beauty." It would seem that body piercings and tattoos fall into this category. Does anything say, "Look at me," more than turning your body into a walking billboard? Pope St. Gregory the Great said, "There are some who think that attention to finery and costly dress is no sin. Surely, if this were no fault, the Word of God would not say so expressly that the rich man who was tortured in hell had been clothed in purple and fine linen." However, St. Thomas tells us, "Women may lawfully adorn themselves, whether to maintain the fitness of their estate, or even by adding something thereto in order to please their husbands." St. Thomas also tells us that there's a variation in regard to the prideful wearing of clothing. And that arises when people take excessive pleasure and inordinate attachment to certain clothes. An example of this is when a man likes soft clothes such as silk pajamas. And St. Thomas Aquinas tells us that this is related to effeminacy. Of the attachment to certain type of clothing, St. Augustine says, "We must avoid excessive pleasure in the use of these things, so that whereas it lay hidden while under the restraint of established morality, it displays its deformity in a most lawless outbreak." The other form of immodesty is wearing clothing that might incite others to lust. St. Thomas said, "Women who have no husband cannot without sin desire to give lustful pleasure to those who see them, because this is to incite them to sin. And if indeed they adorn themselves with this intention of provoking others to lust, they sin mortally. Whereas if they do so from frivolity or from vanity for the sake of ostentation, it is not always mortal, but sometimes venial." And the same applies to men in this respect. And this is proved by Scripture. "Behold, a woman meeteth him in harlot's attire, prepared to deceive souls." However, please note that St. Thomas also says, "A woman may use means to please her husband, lest through despising her he fall into adultery. Wherefore, if a married woman adorn herself in order to please her husband, she can do this without sin." St. Thomas adds, "It is in itself sinful for a woman to wear man's clothes or vice versa, especially since this may be a cause of sensuous pleasure, and is expressly forbidden in the law," meaning Deuteronomy. "Nevertheless, this may be done sometimes without sin on account of some necessity, such as lack of other clothing or some other similar motive." St. Thomas tells us that local custom should be considered in determining what is immodest. St. Augustine said, "Those offenses which are contrary to the customs of men are to be avoided according to the customs generally prevailing, so that a thing agreed upon and confirmed by custom or law of any city or nation may not be violated at the lawless pleasure of any, whether citizen or foreigner. For any part which does not harmonize with its whole is offensive." St. Thomas brings us some clarity to this issue, but some things are still fuzzy. For instance, he tells us that local custom is a factor in determining what is and what isn't immodest. But I wonder, would it have been appropriate to adhere to the customs of dress in Sodom and Gomorrah? And what about the changing customs in our post-Christian society, where acceptability changes not only from generation to generation, but from decade to decade and almost from year to year? And what about popular clothing that is considered acceptable in our society, but it is designed to incite lust? What if the drivers of what is customary in our society are groups that are hostile to Christianity? Are there inherent benchmarks beyond which we must not pass? And we're going to discuss that in future installments. Well, I hope you enjoyed this installment. We'll be back again in about a week with another one. But in the meantime, please check out my Facebook page, which is linked down below. Every day I post additional content that you won't find on this YouTube channel. Please also check out the Ascent of Mount Carmel group, which is a discussion group based primarily on the writings of St. John of the Cross. And please pray for the church. No one like me.